10 water slides in Australia. Sorta. I'm only going to be ranking slides I've ridden so I can give a list with a bit more accuracy. So there will be no water slides from the Wet n Wild in Sydney, seeing I haven't gone there yet. So these top 10s take a very long time to make, so if you could go down and give this video a like, that would mean so much. And while you're down there, maybe consider hitting that subscribe button. So if you guys go on to agree or even a disagree with my list, make sure you let me know in the comment section below. I would love to see your guys' lists. Lists? Lists. 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 Am I saying that right? Oh, whatever. That's enough talking for me. Let's jump straight into my top 10 water slides in Australia.
Number 10.
So just scraping its way into the top 10 is Kamikaze. Now, I know this is a fan favourite at Wet n Wild, but to be honest, I'm not too fussed on it. After that first big drop, which don't get me wrong, is amazing, but after that, nothing else really happens. You just go up and down a few times at a very slow speed. So Kamikaze is 11 meters high and drops you at 50 kilometers an hour on a 70 degree angle. So as you can see by those stats, it's definitely in the category of thrilling. But all over, just doesn't have enough exciting elements to get it any higher on the list.
Number 9.
So next on the list is the most recent slides added to the Gold Coast collection, and that is the fully 6 slides at Whitewater World. So before I talk about the selection, I'm going to explain how I'm going to be ranking these slides on the list so you're not confused later on. So if you look at the fully 6 slides here, you can see that they're all together and made by the same manufacturer. So I'm going to be counting them all as one slide, even though there's multiple of them. But if you look at the previous selection on the list, Kamikaze, I'm going to be ranking that by itself, because it is by itself. Hopefully that makes sense. If not, well then I don't know. So the fully 6 slides coming at number 9 for basically one reason. Consistency. You're definitely wondering what I mean by that, but I'll explain. Every slide on the fully 6 is just good. There are no bad ones, but there are no amazing ones either. So by the name of it, you can probably guess how many slides there are. 7? No, I'm just joking. Jeez, I need to get some better jokes. So obviously there are 6 slides and I'd love to give some statistics on them, but I couldn't find any information anywhere. So we'll give it some statistics ourselves. So the fully 6 slides look to be moderately tall, moderately fast, and moderately fun. So if I were to pick a best slide on the tower, it would definitely go to the two that go straight down in the middle, because to me, they are the most fun and thrilling out of all of them. So basically, the fully 6 slides offer enough to make the list, but don't offer enough to get it any higher. So that's why it comes in at number 9.
Number 8.
Coming in at number 8 on the list is the Rip. Now, this is a slide I don't really hear getting talked about enough for my liking, because the Rip is one of the most fun experiences you'll have at a water park and has the stats to back it up. The Rip stands at 16 meters high, so far that's the tallest slide on the list. The Rip then launches you into a 12 meter total darkness drop where I tell ya, you build up some speed on that thing. I was shocked the first time I went on this. After that crazy drop, you then go flying into a toilet bowl? It looks like a toilet bowl to me. Okay, we might refer to it as the vortex. So you go around the vortex a couple times until you lose all that speed you just built up, and then you get to experience your last bit of excitement for the ride and go down a nice little drop. So the ride layout is pretty simple, but a whole lot of fun, especially when you have 4 people in the tube, because the momentum you build up is unreal. And one of my favorite things about the Rip, in my opinion, it has the best color scheme. So that gave it some bonus points as well, because it has to look nice. So some may argue for the Rip to be higher and some may say lower, but in my opinion, I've picked the perfect spot for the Rip at number 8.
Number 7.
Coming in at the 7th spot is the Temple of Huey slides at Whitewater World. So just like the fully 6, there's a few slides to break down here. But before we do that, I'd like to say, I think these have to be the most complete and well-made slides on the coast, because there are so many great options of water slides in such a small space. So, where do we start? What about we talk about the Broken Head slide first? So the Broken Head stands at 13 meters high, so that is the same as every other slide on the tower, and it also has a length of 99 meters. So it's not the longest or fastest slide ever, but what it does rely on are these crazy dark tide turns from the illusion and not knowing where you're going. So if you're scared to get a drink from the fridge in the middle of the night, don't go on this ride. Trust me. So the second slide on the tower is the Cut Snake. The Cut Snake is a little bit longer than the Broken Head slide, as it has a length of 104 meters. So it's not that much longer, but a little bit. So the Cut Snake is basically the same as the Broken Head slide, but this time you can see where you're going. But I think I enjoyed this one more because it is a little bit faster, and with water slides, speed is key. Which will bring us on to our third slide, the Screaming Right-Handers. You probably thought I was gonna say how fast and great the slide is, didn't you? I'm gonna be brutally honest here and say this has to be the most boring slide ever. It's not as long, it's not as fast, and all over, it's just not as good as the other slides. Like, it does everything the same as the Broken Head slide and the Cut Snake, but just way worse. So this slide is probably the only thing holding it down from being any higher on the list. So all over, these slides are great for all ages, and there's a mixture of everything, so that's why it comes in at number 7.
Number 6.
So seeing we just talked a while on the last slides, let's keep the next few short and snappy. Coming in at number 6 is the Wedgie at Whitewater World. So the Wedgie is sort of a one-trick pony, but it works. So on this slide, you'll start off by walking up a mountain of stairs all the way to the top, and once you reach the top, you'll hop in some sort of yellow tube and wait for the voice to count you down. On one, a trapdoor beneath you will open and you will plunge down a 17 metre high, nearly vertical drop and travel through an 81 metre long tube at amazing speeds of 45 kilometres an hour. At the end, you'll hit the water and proceed to do what the name of the ride implies. So the Wedgie may be a one trick pony, but it does offer one of the biggest thrills on the coast, so that's why it comes in at number 6.
Number 5.
So coming in at number 5, we have got the Aqualoop. So everything I said about the Wedgie, you can say about the Aqualoop, but increase everything times 2. Not literally, because they are both the same height, but the Aqualoop is faster and has a loop. Yes, a loop on a water slide. So the Aqualoop, in my opinion, is the most adrenaline rushing slide on the coast. So like the Wedgie, it is a one trick pony, but if you're looking for one big thrill, well then climb up the mountain of stairs and head on the Aqualoop. Oh, and one other thing to mention, you have the possibility of getting stuck on this slide, so that added some bonus thrill points for me. So basically, if you want a thrill, head on the Aqualoop.
Number 4.
So at number 4, I've chosen my personal favourite slide on the coast, and that is the Bro at Whitewater World. The Bro is just fun, and it's not really the slide itself that makes it fun. It's the racing factor. So the Bro has 8 lanes that you can choose from to race against friends, family, or even strangers to see who can get to the bottom first. And when you have 6 to 8 people that you're coming up against, it can be such a fun experience. And this slide is one heck of a masterpiece to look at as well. With the orange and blue colour scheme and the tubes that wind in and out of each other, it is just one heck of a slide. But there is a downside, and that is the walk up to the top. It's not that bad doing it once or twice, but you'll find yourself doing it multiple times because this slide is just too addictive. So for me, this is my favorite slide on the coast, so that's why it comes in at number 4.
Number 3.
So now we're on to the top 3. This is where the big dogs lie. Coming in at 3rd place is the Black Hole at Wet n Wild. Now as we film this, the Black Hole is currently under maintenance, so all the footage of this slide in action will be from other creators, which will be credited on screen or in the description. So do you guys remember me talking about the Broken Head slide a little bit earlier? Yeah, well that is this slide, but times everything by 100. So the Black Hole starts you off at a pretty decent height and then sends you down 165 meters length of tubing at amazing speeds of 40 kilometers an hour. But I'm pretty sure you know why that's so impressive, because you can't see where you're going whatsoever. And another thing I love about this slide is that there's 2 of them. So that means the line will be moving a lot quicker than other slides. So the Black Hole is just one of those crazy rides, so that's why it claims the 3rd spot.
Number 2.
Alright, so now we're onto our second last spot of the list. Coming in at number 2 is the Hydro Coaster at Whitewater World. I tell ya, I was so tempted to put this at number 1 because it is just that good. So this slide is definitely 100% the most complicated slide in Australia due to the fact it's driven by motors. I think they're motors. We'll just call them motors. So normally with water slides, you walk up a mountain load of stairs and get to the top and then slide down one big bit of tubing or something along those lines. But with the Hydro Coaster, you're not just sliding down, you're also sliding up from the motors. It is such a cool feeling due to the fact there's only one of them in Australia, which firstly is just ridiculous. I don't know why we haven't built any more, but we move. But those aren't the only reasons it's made it to number 2. This water coaster is the perfect mixture between family and thrill, which means it can be ridden by all ages. And my favourite part about this slide, it is long. With it being 236 metres long, so to my knowledge, that is the longest slide on the Gold Coast. So yeah, basically, get yourself down to Whitewater World and ride the Hydro Coaster.
Number 1.
And finally, for our number 1 spot, we have got, drumroll please, the Green Room and Tornado at Whitewater World and Wet n Wild. Now, you may be wondering why I have 2 different slides from 2 different parks here. Well, it's because they're not different. Well, they are, but they're not. So the Green Room and Tornado are a clone water slide, meaning they're built exactly the same, just with a different theme and location. So in my opinion, these are the 2 best slides on the coast, because they are thrilling, you get wet, and a whole family can ride them. But when I say thrilling, I don't mean thrilling as in screaming your head off.
A few moments later.
What the hell is that scream? I mean thrilling as it gets your heart going a little, which means it's a perfect ride for all ages. So on these 2 slides, you'll start up on the top, obviously, and you'll go around in circles for a few times until you're met with the best bit of the ride, in my opinion, the steep drop. After you fly down there, you'll go into a big funnel until you lose all that speed you built up. And then the ride's over. It's simple, but effective. If you haven't tried any of these 2 slides yet, please do, because you won't be disappointed. If I had to pick a favorite out of the 2, it would have to be the Green Room, as you don't have to carry your tube up. But I do think the Tornado looks better. So in my opinion, the tornado and the green room are the two best slides on the coast, so that's why it comes in at number one. That's the end of the video. If you guys enjoyed, make sure you smack that like button and subscribe, and make sure you turn on post notifications so you don't miss a video. Now quickly before we end the video, I'd like to say a big thanks to Mum for helping me film these sorts of videos and standing out in the hot sun for hours. I really do appreciate it. Without her, these sorts of videos wouldn't be possible. So yeah, that's it for me. Make sure to let me know if you agree or disagree with my list in the comment section below, and I'll see you next time. Bye bye! Whoa! Hola.